We'll start with the session. So my name is Dr. Ajit Jha. I'm from Quantum Corp Health Private Limited. First of all, I welcome everyone on this particular webinar, which we are having it today. It's by the name of Healthy Diet. The overall concept of this webinar is to understand the importance of diet and how to keep a well-maintained diet for a physical and mental well-being. Before I start with the session, you know, just a small request from me and my company to all of you who are watching this webinar is that, since you might be aware that we are on the seventh day of the uprise of the third wave, which already been marked as by many of them, you know, it's already a third wave now. And, you know, we have more than 35,000 cases yesterday pan India. So I would request everyone that please be safe, start maintaining the basic COVID protocol of sanitizing yourself, maintaining social distancing, and also, you know, wear mask. It's something, again, we are falling into the trap of this COVID pandemic and the overall third wave. And it's very important that you as an individual take care of you and your family with utmost importance, so that, you know, we can stop this overall, you know, spread of this pandemic. Going forward, I will just give you a brief about Quantum Corp Health, and then I will hand over the session to the speaker of our the session, Ms. Nigdha Shah. So, talking about Quantum Corp Health, you know, we provide the spectrum of centralized health services, and we are based in Mumbai. I hope you guys can hear my voice and my screen also. If yes, if you can just put it in the chat box, yes, I would rather be happy to proceed further. Just put in the chat box, yes, if you can view my screen and my voice as audible as well. Thank you so much for the confirmation. Okay, moving forward. So we mark our existence by serving complete and comprehensive healthcare facilities, and we are headed by a team of doctors under one organization, and we provide pan-India services. We have one of the largest team of doctors, highly qualified medical professionals, to take care of your health. It is headed by Dr. Bhavya Vankar, who is the director of Quantum Corp Health, and Dr. Narendra Vankar, who is the CEO. The services which we cater includes the corporate wellness service as well as the individual health service as well. We provide services like pre-employment health checkup, annual health checkup, pre-policy health checkup, corporate health audit, which falls under the category of corporate wellness. Also, group medical insurance is a segment which we are now catering to. Coming down to the individual segment or services, we are now into COVID-19 testing as well. Since the first wave, second wave, and now the third wave, we are giving our support to majority of the corporates by providing this COVID-19 home visit testing. So anyone of you who is watching this webinar wants to get your RT-PCR done at home for you or for your near and dear ones, you can get in touch with us, and you know, we'll be happy to serve you in this kind of a scenario. We also have a health support system, which is plug and play health support system. We are also into online doctor consultation, where in just with a call, you can speak to our consultants or our general practitioners and get all the related updates and the service of doctor consultation. We also have smart medical devices. We have in-house doctor and paramedic service. We also provide ambulance pan India service. We conduct such kind of routine health talk shows and webinars. We are also into IPD and OPD, women health, first aid training and medical camps. And we also provide to a certain extent some kind of a mild wellness you know, services. Talking about today's session, so as I already informed you, our speaker for this session is Ms. Nigdha Shah. She is a bariatric nutritionist and a consultant dietitian. She has over 25 years of experience in the field of nutrition and dietetics. She has a clientele based across a lot of countries. She believes in framing personalized diets and aims in providing a holistic lifestyle changes to her clients. She has a postgraduate diploma in dietetics and applied nutrition, and she's also a certified diabetes educator and certified bariatric nutritionist. Talking about her, you know, I personally I got a lot of help from her, because I started taking the tips whichever she shared in previous webinars, and you know, I also started losing weight and feeling much more physically healthy, and well, it has implicated my mental health as well. So thank you once again, Ms. Nigdha, for providing your time and coming out here for this session. And I would hand over the session to you, ma'am. I hope you can listen to me, and if you can just speak. Okay, 1 second.
Yeah.
Okay. I am also stopping the screen share so that you can start.
I'll start. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. I'm not able to share my screen. Can you just allow me to do that, Dr. Ajit?
Surely.
Yeah.
Just give me a second.
Yeah.
I guess now you can, if you can try, ma'am.
Yeah, I'm trying. Yeah. Are the slides visible? Dr. Ajit, are the slides visible? Dr. Ajit, are the slides visible? Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Quantum, for inviting me for this webinar. I wish every one of you all here who are present have a healthy, happy 2022 and stay safe from this third wave of COVID and try to incorporate these tips today, which I'm going to share with you all. So, yeah, so New Year's resolution. So it's a trend, right? As soon as our third December starts and we decide, okay, what will be my New Year's resolutions? So normally we tend to take such resolutions like exercise daily, I'll spend more time with my family, I'll learn some new skills, I'll have a good sound sleep routine. So there are many things which we always like to do and we take these as our New Year's resolution. But do we ever reflect back, like how long are we able to sustain these resolutions? You know, there are many hindrances or there is like lack of motivation. Say maybe within a week, I'm tired of eating healthy or I find excuses for not to exercise. So these New Year resolutions, normally people say they tend to be broken, right? So I would say that once you think of these new resolutions, try to be realistic, try to be mentally ready to follow these. We need to prepare ourselves whether if we are going to write down, say, suppose 10 New Year resolutions, we need to prepare ourselves for those so that we can follow it up and don't be too hard on yourself. So I feel that instead of taking New Year's resolutions, we need to make it transform these resolutions into our habits. Okay. So for example, I like these things, like instead of like less talking, more of listening, less planning, let's do more, less soda, more of tea or green tea, less of junk food, more into salads, less of complaining, let's be more encouraging. Instead of worrying, less of worrying, we need to hope more, less doubting, more believing, less lazing around, more working on, less of frowning, more of smiling. So these are some of the resolutions or which we need to make into our habits that stay with us lifetime. Now, I would like here to share 20 tips for a healthy 2022 and beyond, because what I'm going to say here is this, which you all know, you all are, maybe you all are aware of what I'm going to discuss today. So this can be a kind of a remembrance, a reminder to you all, as well as it might help for people who don't follow these tips. So I have chosen the one of those tips or some of these things which I find it very useful. So let's start with the first one, okay? And we'll have a question answer session later on. So I have not kept my talk for a long duration. I want it to be more interactive session. So first we start with eat the rainbow, okay? So normally we have heard about a balanced food groups, balanced diet. We have heard of the whole plate. We have heard of the food guide pyramid. So today I thought of sharing you this concept in a different form, like eat the rainbow. So eat vegetables, fruits, you know, the grains of multicolor. When we eat a colorful diet or foods which are rich in all the different antioxidants, phytochemicals, vitamins, minerals. So we need to incorporate food groups from all different color foods in our day-to-day diet so that our requirements for vitamins, minerals, proteins, everything is met. So let's eat a rainbow for our health. So you can see in the white, we have things like garlic, onion, radish. The yellow has all our papaya or the citrus fruits. So sorry, not papaya, comes in orange. The lemon, pear, pineapple, all these are bananas, are these yellow category. Orange are the carrots. This is a good season to have carrot, your pumpkin, your papaya, all these oranges, they come into this. Red is your apple, strawberries, you know. Purple is you can incorporate purple cabbage in your day-to-day, you know, salads, pumpkins, purple grapes, brinjals, not pumpkins. So all the purple color foods, and you know, all the green leafy vegetables like palak, methi. This is a season for where you get a lot of green veggies. So try to incorporate them daily. So once you eat the rainbow, you're getting all the nutrients for your day-to-day diet. Now, the second tip is start your day with a glass of water. Now, just how many of you all do that? You all can just write in your chat box. So it's a reminder for you. So many times when I take down the history of the patients, they start their day with a cup of tea or a cup of coffee, which is not a good thing to do. Hydrating you in the morning as a first thing, it aids your digestion. It helps to keep your skin healthy. It boosts your energy. And there are many other benefits of drinking water. You all know that. So I'll give you simple tips here. How do you remember yourself? How to remember that you need so much amount of water daily? A simple formula to meet your daily water requirements is your weight into 30, okay, will give you, for example, you're weighing 50 kg. So 15 to 30 is 1500 ml. So you need minimum of 1500 ml of water daily. If it's a summer season, then you need extra 500 ml. And if you are a sedentary worker, but if you're an athlete or if you're having a lot of cardio or if you're a heavy worker, then your requirements go higher. So basically around 2.5 to 3 liters of water per day is essential for you. So the best way is to keep 1 liter of bottle on your table and try to finish at least 3 liters in a day. So starting a day or day with a glass of water really helps everyone in the long run. Now, this is very important because we are always indoors, and now seeing the COVID scenario, we are still scared of getting out of the house, right? But we tend to do it for our work. So why not wear a proper tight-fitting mask and get out and just get exposed to sun every day? You're getting your natural vitamin D. Vitamin D is very essential nutrient, and maybe like 10 years back, we never heard of vitamin D deficiency, but today it is commonly seen. Most of the vegetarians are, and other people also lack vitamin D because of lack of exposure to sunlight. We are mostly indoors, but mind you, when you go out in the sun, please don't apply a sunscreen. If you are going to apply a sunscreen lotion, your vitamin D will not be absorbed in your body. Now, making nuts and seeds an integral part of your daily diet is very important. Earlier, this was considered as a rich man's food. For example, almonds, walnuts, they are quite expensive, but there are even other like groundnut and chana. Groundnuts are a cheap source of nuts, and it is beneficial in small amount, in moderate amounts. So if you cannot, include almond and walnut daily, at least start incorporating groundnuts. So now these nuts are excellent source of vitamin E and B vitamins. And as you can see what I've written here, I'm not going to say everything, but I can help you to say how can you start. Like start your day with 2 to 3 almonds, 2 walnuts, 1 anjeer or 1 khajur, and have a variety of mixed nuts as an evening snack. Okay, or you can even have some certain flaxseed or chia seeds in your salads. So try and incorporate these in your daily diet. Stay away from ultra processed foods. Now, you know, these foods are very tempting and very tasty, and you really like to munch on these. But you can make these as your last choice of preference. Whenever possible, go for healthy food choices. But yeah, in case you're traveling and where there is no access to healthy foods, you can go for these, but again, in very small quantities. Okay, so the routine which we have, like chai or biscuits, you know, try and replace this biscuit with healthy homemade khakras, or maybe you can have chana, chilling chana, or you can make sprout moong dal. So try and think of, healthy options so that you get the makhanas are very commonly available now, but try to have the homemade makhanas rather than the outside one, which you get the flavors and other things because they have extra added salt in it. So try to be away from these ultra processed foods. Now, protein is very important. We normally, Indian diets, we lack protein. We have very minimal amount of protein because our diets are more carbohydrate based. So one simple thing which you all can think is try and plan every meal with a protein source. For example, a traditional Indian breakfast, they are very high in carbohydrate. For example, hum log kya khate hai? Subah utke poha, upma. You know, these are the routine idlis is good, okay? So what we can do, we can incorporate some protein with it. For example, if you're having poha, you can incorporate groundnuts or sprouts in your poha. You can have a glass of milk or 2 boiled eggs if you are vegetarian with a plate of upma. So you balance your meals and try to consume at least one source of protein in every meal of the day. Now, you all know the sources of protein, so I don't want to go deep into it. But don't go excess or overboard on proteins too, because excess proteins will harm your kidneys. So try to have around 0.8 to 1 kg of, 0.8 to 1 gram of protein per kg body weight is the ideal requirements for your proteins. Now, minimize your sugar intake. You know, these three white poisons in our diet, maida, salt, and sugar, they are like poisons for our body. We don't require them. See, whatever we are eating finally gets converted into sugar, right? So try to minimize or restrict your direct sugar, like chai mein shakkar dalna hai, to dheere dheere kam karke band kar do. Even if you're not diabetic, you don't require that excess refined sugar, right? So it's all the taste of your mouth and it's a habit that you have formed through years of having tea with sugar. So slowly and steadily, you can decrease and stop the sugar. Again, I would advise you for weight loss patients, like those people who are going on weight loss, start using sugar-free instead of sugar. You don't need to do that. Again, sugar-free all are chemical-based, right? So you try to develop a taste, decrease your refined carbs. So wherever possible, try avoid your white bread. Even brown bread, they say it's like, they're advertising. You don't know whether they're really adding color to your brown, to the bread, or they're adding real wheat to it. So try and avoid bread to a larger extent. You can mix the same recipes with your chapatis. Like, for example, if you are having a sandwich, you can incorporate the same stuffing in your chapatis and just toast it. So have more of complex carbohydrates rather than the refined carbs. So if you start doing it slowly, it's going to be helpful in your long run. Now, trans fat is a bad fat, which we need to avoid. Again, those processed foods, which I had said, they are very high in trans fat. So once you start avoiding these processed and preserved items, slowly the trans fat will decrease in your day-to-day diet. But fat is important. Your healthy fats, like your oils like groundnut oil, rice bran oil, olive oil, all these oils, mustard oil, tilled sesame oil, they are all good oils. But again, the quantity is very important. There are some people who stop fat completely, but this is not the right thing to do, because our body requires fat. It provides you the fat-soluble vitamins. It makes your food tasty and palatable. Like, for example, your joints, and they require some fat, you know, for your daily, for its functioning. So a moderate amount of healthy fats is a necessity in your diet. So please don't completely go fat-free diet. Okay. Now, again, use plenty of herbs and spices in our daily diet, you know, and this, we Indians are very lucky because our medicine stays in our kitchen, right? So whatever spices we use in day-to-day cooking is giving us some immunity, is giving us some health benefits in our day-to-day. So, you know, turmeric latte has become famous in the West, but we already had it in India, right? So having a cup of turmeric milk daily is a good way of giving immunity to ourselves, especially in this time of corona. So try to incorporate like garlic, ginger, black pepper, and all the other spices on a daily basis. Practice mindful eating. Concentrate on your food. Now, this is very important. We don't realize that eating is not just an activity, but it is providing us energy to our body. See, when we are eating, we don't even wait for the entire plate to be, you know, full. जैसे जैसे आता रह जाता है, हम लोग खाना चालू कर देते. I would advise, just think, just wait. Let the whole plate be, you know, filled with your with your meals, whatever, like rice, dal, chapati, vegetable. Just in your mind, just say any prayer which you know. Express gratitude towards the food that you have got. Thank God for the food that you have eaten. So by the time you start praying and looking at the food, your saliva starts secreting. And the more the saliva secretes, the more your food is going to get digested, okay? So doing that, it's a scientific thing, you know. You are expressing gratitude towards God that you are getting a meal, which so many people don't get. Plus, you are giving time for your saliva secretion, which is going to help in the digestion of your food. So things like watching TV while eating, or, you know, just you are on your mobile all the time watching Insta Reels or whatever, stop doing all that. Let eating be not a task, but enjoy your meals, you know, because once you start enjoying your meals, it's going to give you a beneficial effect. So concentrate on your food, do mindful, just be relaxed while eating. Don't think of your work or your negative, negative emotions and all that. Don't get them while you're eating on your table. So mindful eating really is going to help you to have a good health. Now, get rid of excess belly fat. Now, an interesting thing I would like to share with you all is, we Indians are many times thin fat people, you know. Even if we are thin, if our weight is below its normal weight, or whether we are underweight, we might have a high fat percentage in our body. Now, especially excess belly fat is very dangerous for our health. You are more prone to cardiovascular diseases, insulin resistance and type 2 diabetes, colorectal cancer, sleep apnea, high blood pressure. So all these are a risk if you have a high excess belly fat. So it's very important you start working on reducing this fat. So having a healthy diet, exercising regularly, especially doing your abdominal exercises, is going to help you to get rid of this excess belly fat. fill your home with house plants. Now, this is a little bit away from my topic, but I thought let me share it with you because I did that in the lockdown and it really, you know, improved my mood and I really started enjoying staying in my room. So filling your home with house plants is a very positive thing for your health. So start doing it if you haven't done yet. Smile often, laugh daily. It boosts your physical and mental health. Okay, so right now you all can start just smiling or laughing, so that you see, once you start laughing, look at the energy that creates a positivity in you. So try and do it daily, I would say. You can join a laughter club or you can learn some laughing exercises. You have a lot of these things on your YouTube channels. So do it daily because that's really going to improve, especially in this third wave of COVID where you're always scared. What if I'm the next one to get it? Just don't think that, you know, think positive. Try to help people, those who are already suffering around you for COVID. So the more you smile, the more you laugh, it's going to improve your health and it's going to give positivity to your other members of your family. Now, sweat every day, exercise daily. You all know how important it is to exercise, you know, but it's just our lack of, you know, motivation or the laziness, which, you know, comes in between this. So I would say just start doing whatever you like. If you like dancing, start learning belly dance or start, you know, just do Zumba or just put on a song, Bollywood song and start dancing. So the thing is, if you like going for cycling or swimming, which is not, of course, swimming is not advisable in this scenario, but climbing up stairs or whatever. So like you need to do these exercises, whatever you choose on a daily basis. There are four forms of exercise. One is cardio, one is strength, one is flexibility, one is balancing. So we need to incorporate exercises which give you all these benefits. So what I could say after listening to me, you all can decide 1 hour in the whole day where you will do some form of exercise. If it is not possible for you to go down and do it or hit a gym, you can do it indoors at your home. There are so many videos on walking, yoga and, you know, cardio walking exercises. You can just download any of these videos and do with that. So please start exercising on a daily basis. Now stand up every 30 minutes while working for hours together. This is again for sedentary workers, for people, corporate people who are sitting at home and working for long hours together. Start, you know what my husband did this lockdown? We got a small bench and he used to put it on his working table and put a laptop on it. And he would stand for at least 20 to 30 minutes and sit down for 2 hours, again stand, again sit. So when you're doing this, it's strengthening your leg muscles, your core muscles, and you won't get those aches and pains which you get, backache and all, when you, so please try to improve your posture and it will prevent you from getting that belly fat. You know, if you're going to sit for long hours, you're more prone to incorporating fat on your belly area. So please start doing this every day. Even if for housewives and all, if you all are sitting for 1 hour, just get up and walk for 15 hours, stand. Get some, see, you know, some people, they exercise for 1 hour, it is stretch and the entire day they are just sedentary. Don't do that. You know, keep yourself active throughout the day. Now make meditation, yoga, integral part of your life. It's very important. This is our Indian heritage, you can say Indian tradition, like yoga. And now since the West has started, we are also coming back to it, okay? But we need to see that how healthy our ancestors were. So yoga and meditation on a daily basis, if you incorporate, you are going to really get a good health and you won't require a lot of medicines. So you will be free from medicines if you make this an integral part of your life. Prioritize your sleep cycle. Listen to your body. I would say because of excess screen time and, you know, we are more because of the Amazon and we are getting everything is on touch of a screen, right? So our sleep is getting disturbed because of that, plus the stress which is coming due to the COVID. So we need to see that we get sound sleep for at least 6 to 7 hours, because there are a lot of benefits of good sleep, which you have already written here. I'm not going to say the same thing, but try to just, you know, be away from all your gadgets half an hour at least before your sleeping time. Okay, you can just read a good positive book, or you can listen to sound music before sleeping. Calm yourself down. You can do yoga nidra. So once you get your sleep cycle into your rhythm, you will even, it will prevent you from getting all the hormonal disturbances and other stress factors. So it will help again to, you know, deal with excess stress if you regularize your sleep cycle. Now, this is very important, spending me time. We are so engaged in making other people happy, you know, earning money and doing our household duties. So we are all the time doing something. But do we think of ourselves? Do we spend time with ourselves? We don't do that, okay? It's very easy to say, but really doing it is very, very rare. So I would say this can be one of your resolution, is to spend time with yourself at least for 10 to 15 minutes. Engage in some activities which you love to do, okay? It could be just call a friend, talk with your loved one, or just read a good book or listen to music. Or if you like stitching or embroidery, just do that a bit. So do something which you enjoy. Spend time with your family. This is again, you know, because everyone is getting self-centered, and we are, you know, we don't really want to eat. It's like I've seen many families, like all the meal times are different, you know. Pehle ek jan aata hai, phir dusre, you know, like it is not everybody's eating together, which was happening years back. So, you know, the benefits of eating together as family is where there are many benefits. For example, it encourages attachment. Again, it brings a lot of positive emotions. It helps a child to develop a healthy eating pattern. If you're going to eat healthy, your child is going to copy that, right? So especially for people who have young children, please try eating healthy all the time so that your kids pick up that practice of eating healthy meals. So if you're not doing it, at least try either a breakfast or a dinner. Try to, you know, combine and eat together. So that will give you a lot of positivity. Lastly, but not the least, I would say practice the COVID safety protocols. Don't be prone, don't fall prey to COVID at all. If you haven't, be thankful for yourself. Sanitize, wear a proper mask, maintain social distancing. So we need to fight against this COVID. So I hope this was something to take away. So before I start the question answer session, I would just end this session with something positive, like just 2022, just go for it. Start that business, try that practice, implement that ritual, you know, do whatever you wanted to do. Set those boundaries, approach that person if you always wanted to. Go for that run or walk which you always wish to, okay? Visualize your goals, book that time off, watch those documentaries which you have never seen, read that material, share your love. And finally, think positively, exercise daily, eat healthy, work hard, stay strong, worry less, dance more, love often, and just be happy. Thank you for the patient listening. And let's start with the question answer session. Dr. Ajit, can you please take over?
Yes, thank you so much for such a beautiful session, Nikita. I mean, it was something which was very informative, and everything was really good, especially the last part from Vex King, you know, let's the 2022 wala part, you know, that was really good, and I hope everyone liked it. So let's start with the oral session now. Yeah, this one.
Yeah,
exactly. So let's start with the QA session. This is rather the most important and the most loved part of the session, wherein, you know, people can start questioning and then we will be there. So I would request everyone to put all the questions in the chat box, and then accordingly we will answer them one by one, so that, you know, everyone knows about the answer. So to start off with, can you discuss point number 11? This is from Ms. Pallavi Pinge.
Yeah.
Point number 11, ma'am, if you can just help out with the answer for this. We'll have to go to point number 11 for this answer.
Yeah.
The trade of excess belly fat. Okay.
So what I wanted to say that the excess belly fat, which we are having, the subcutaneous fat and the visceral fat, we need to reduce the fat from this because it is more prone to diseases such as cardiovascular, insulin and type 2 diabetes, sleep apnea. We are more prone to blood pressure. So many people know they are thin overall, but they only have fat over the abdomen. So I would try to say that you have to focus on the fat loss from your abdomen by doing abdominal strengthening exercises and following a well-balanced low-fat diet.
Okay, I hope this answers your question, Ms. Pallavi. Next is from Sai Sudha Patro. How to avoid white rice?
How to avoid white rice?
Okay. Yeah.
See, the problem is white rice is not a culprit, but the amount of rice is a culprit. People love eating rice. You can take one serving of it, but you need to add a lot of dal and vegetables to it so that you are getting the other nutrients. And again, brown rice, there are some rice available which they say is brown, but we exactly don't know whether they're adding color or is it really high fiber. But the South Indian people who use the brown rice, which are thick and they are really the ones which are more fiber rich rice. So again, the quantity of rice is important. If you love rice, you can take it. But again, as I said, have a lot of vegetables and dal and all with it, then it's fine.
Great. Again, one more question from Mr. Sai. How to avoid more carbohydrates? And also, he has clubbed this with how to reduce belly fat. Can you please advise on this? So, how to avoid carbohydrate, more carbohydrates in diet, and how to reduce belly fat? If you can answer this, ma'am.
Yeah. So, for example, it again is very individualized. Now, you need to go into your detailed history and depending on your calories, we calculate. So, go to a qualified dietitian or nutritionist who will tell you that you need so much amount of carbs. But on a general basis, depending again on your height and weight, we calculate that you need, suppose, say 100 grams of carbohydrates or 200 grams of carbohydrate. So overall, there's nothing general, but if you want, you can replace your carbs, like you can jawar, bajra, and the nachni. All these are healthy carbs compared because they have good nutrients. So again, as I said, that there's not a rule that I can see. You can have like 10 chapati, you can have 4 chapati, it's very individualized. So
great.
Yeah.
Next question is from Mr. Ajay Kumar Reddy. Can you please tell us about the ideal South Indian diet plan for diabetic? So I think he is diabetic, or maybe someone he knows is diabetic, and he is talking about the ideal South Indian diet plan for a diabetic patient.
Again, this is so very much personalized, so there's nothing general, but I would say for South Indian, if they are very happy with their rice portion, the diabetic can take the rice, but again, as I said, in a proper proportionate or the amount as per their calculations, but along with that, you have to have good sources of vegetables and dal and proteins and all that. So again, these are very individualized questions, so if they can get back to me, I can give them a detailed diet plan.
Perfect. Next is from Mr. Hitesh, and his question is jawar, bajra, chapati more healthy than wheat chapati? Does more calcium food get good sleep? Okay. So there are two questions. One is about chapatis, that is jawar, bajra, chapati more healthy? And the other question is about does more calcium food get good sleep?
Okay. I'm not aware of the high calcium foods related to your sleep. Okay. But they say that one glass of milk, warm milk, gives good sleep, okay? So you can try it out. A glass of hot milk will give you better sleep, okay? And the second part about jawar and bajra, they have more other nutrients, like they have higher protein content, little bit than the wheat, and they have high fiber content. So yes, they are better than wheat, but I wouldn't say you need to really get rid of our wheat. You know, there are many misconceptions that avoid wheat completely. You don't really need to do it if you're not gluten intolerant. So you can have like one day I advise that dinner, you can avoid wheat. You go for jawar, bajri and nachni rotis. But if you like wheat chapati, you can always go for that, depending again on your caloric requirements. So see, nothing in proportion, nothing is bad. Excess is bad. So if you're going to have wheat for 3 times a meal, like breakfast, lunch, dinner, everything consists of wheat, then it's bad.
True. Next question is from Mr. Sridhar, and his question is, white rice and chapatis will release the same glucose to the body. That's his question. So whether it releases the same glucose to the body or not?
Yeah, no, it releases the same, but the white rice will increase the sugar levels higher than the wheat, because wheat has more fiber and rice has less fiber. So that's why we tell diabetic patients that you can't have too much of the rice, because then the sugars will go high. But we tell them to, like, you can have two rotis and a little bit of half cutori of rice, because they are so fond, and some people feel satisfied only after having rice. See, the thing is, when we have rice, we add a lot of dal and vegetables to it, so we feel full. So the feeling of fullness is achieved because of that little rice, which we have been, but there are people who have either rice or either chapati. So again, I would say the rice will increase the sugar faster compared to the chapatis.
Perfect, ma'am. Thank you. Next question is from Mr. Sandeep Pujari. Are all fruits good, especially for diabetic?
Yeah, see, recently when we were studying, we were said this four fruits are bad for diabetes, like banana, chiku, mango, and custard apple. But as the studies have proven, we do allow a mango or a banana or a chiku to diabetic patients once in a while in between meals. So try to have fruits by itself in between your breakfast and lunch. Don't have it together with your breakfast. So frankly speaking, these fruits are considered bad for diabetic, but once in a while we do allow seasonal fruits. So in mango season, my diabetic patients are allowed to have one mango in a day, but in between a meal. So that is it. So you can have, but amount and the quantity, and again the timing is important.
Correct, ma'am. Next, there are good feedbacks also in between. So we have one from Ms. Nalini, excellent session, thank you so much. And one is from Sharvari, very informative session, thank you so much for that. Next question again from Sai sir, please let us know fiber-based food.
Details. So all the complex, the fiber-based foods are all your vegetables, okay, all your salads. Sprouts are a good source of this. Even like khajur and anjeer, they have some amount of fiber. So basically, all the vegetarian sources are rich in fiber. All non-veget sources lack fiber. So if you're a non-vegetarian, please, when you're having chicken or meat or fish, try and incorporate a bowl of salad or a vegetable. Because when I take history, I know the non-vegetarians, they eat only chicken and rice or chicken and roti. So they don't have vegetables and salads in that. So you need to take a source of salads or a fiber-rich source when you're eating non-vegetarian food.
Perfect. Next question is again a feedback from Ms. Pallavi. Useful information. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the feedback. Next question is from RS. I'm not able to get the name of him. We get a lot of digestive, high fiber, etc. biscuits in the market. What is your opinion on this? So when you talk about any digestive biscuits in the market, what is your opinion on this?
See, I would say majority times it's a marketing gimmick by adding these words such as high fiber. Definitely, they will be having more fiber compared to the other brands of biscuits. But again, the trans fat and the preservatives and all are added. So I would advise to please stop having biscuits. You have a lot of homemade options for snacks. So don't fall prey to these words like high fiber, low fat. They add, you know, they may be adding a little bit, but it is not to the satisfaction which we get by giving you homemade foods. So
perfect.
Yeah.
I hope this answers your question as well. So again, few feedbacks from Varsha, informative session. Thank you so much. Meeta ma'am, excellent talk, very satisfying answers. Thank you. Pranali Shah, very good informative session. Thank you. How many minutes walking is good on a weekly basis? This is a question from Mr. Sandeep Pujari.
Yeah.
So how many minutes walking is good?
Aim for at least 45 minutes of brisk walking to 1 hour. Again, if you're not used to it, please don't start on your first day. Start with some warm-up exercises, walk for 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, and then maybe by the end of the week, you start for 45 minutes to 1 hour. Brisk walk.
Next question again from Sai sir. Is there any particular food which reduces fat? I have met you in person, Sai sir. You look very fit. So I don't know whether you require such kind of feedbacks, basically. To answer your question, ma'am.
Yeah, high fat. To reduce high fat, you need to have a high fiber diet. So having warm water, having a high fiber diet will, and of course, exercises are more important. The strength, abdominal strengthening exercises.
Correct. Question from Ms. Meeta Vora. Please suggest some breakfast items which includes proteins.
Yeah. So for vegetarian sources, green moong dal chila, a besan chila with a lot of vegetables or paneer added to it. Mm-hmm. They are very high nutritious. Again, our idlis and dosas made of millets. You know, the new things have come. Millets are very healthy. So incorporating barnyard millet, little millet, and all those different proso millets. When you add these with the green moong dal or split udad dal, and you make dosas or idlis out of these, it's going to increase your protein intake. Sprouts or boiled chana chaat is a very good option for you to start your day. The brown chana, remember we give these chana to our horses. And so, you know, it has a lot of protein and it will just drive you like a good day in the whole day. So correct. Boiled chana, boiled sprouts, all this can be incorporated in your breakfast too, which we normally don't tend to do that.
Perfect. Thank you so much. Next question is, so many messages in between. So we are at, yeah. Again, is millet will cause gastric irritation? So will millets, you know, having millets as in breakfast will cause gastric irritation? That's the question.
See, again, it is depending on individual. You can try it out. But if you soak the millets for 8 hours and then you grind them, so that's not going to give you gastric irritation. So soaking of millets and boiling them or making any dish, like you can cook millets instead of rice. So replacing rice with your different millets, it's a very in thing now. People are doing it. I myself have tried all the millets in different recipes like hanwas and dhoklas and idlis and chilas. So I'm enjoying them and you feel really light after eating millets. So if you're soaking the millets for 8 to 9 hours, it will not cause you gastric. Again, I'll say, it is very individualized, so you can try it out for 2-3 times. If you feel it's irritating you, then you can lessen the quantity of it or the frequency of it.
Great. Next is from Ms. Punita. The question is oats healthier than wheat?
I mean, yeah, so now again, it's a good thing. So I wouldn't tell you to completely replace your wheat with oats. It has excess of soluble fiber. So definitely it's healthy. So you can incorporate it on either one meal of your day can be, or you can add little oats to your wheat, atta, or whatever. So it is healthier in form of, it says high soluble fiber.
Great. Any further question, guys, out there? You know, if you have any questions, you can please put it in the chat box. We'll be happy to answer them. Okay, I think I missed out on one. Achha, there's one question again. What is your opinion about eating local rather than Western foods? Local or rather than Western foods? Okay.
Yeah, I would advise everyone go local and go seasonal. Definitely locally available foods are good and it is good for our farmers too. Okay, when we are buying from them, it's a source of income. True. So we don't need to copy the West. Let them eat what is available there. Let us eat what is available here. So yes, Sharvari, I would really love to be local, eat local and eat seasonal.
How can we give paneer to kids? They don't like raw.
Okay. Yeah, you can incorporate them in parathas. Just grate your paneer and incorporate with all the vegetables, the paneer paratha. Paneer cutlet is a very good recipe.
Option, yeah.
Yeah. So, and so paneer paratha, paneer cutlets, you know, you can add paneer in your chapati dough. I used to, you know, back when I was in US, I used to add tofu to my atta every time I used to cook, you know, knead the dough. So tofu and like soya paneer is also good, but paneer, if you can just grate it and put it in your wheat atta and then make chapatis, they won't come to know.
Okay. Next question is from Mr. Ajay. His question is, please suggest any technology apps to update health.
Yeah, there are many apps, but I would say there are few. I don't really, My Health, there's one app called My Health. Okay, and there are very few, but I would say that instead of going for the apps, you can make a diary, go to a nutritionist, make your own diet chart for yourself, and you can make a diet recall sheet. You can write down every day what you're eating. So,
yeah, I would like to add on to this.
There are quite a few of
yes, there's one which is really famous, which is Healthify Me, and I think now we have started putting advertisements also in TV, you know.
Healthify Me is there is one.
There's one actress who's also brand ambassador of that.
But then again, I would say you should get your individualized diet chart or diet plan, correct, which works for yourself from a qualified nutritionist, because there are many quack dietitians who do 2 months, 3 months course and come in the market. So please ask the, you always go to a qualified, check with their credentials, their degree, and then go to them. That would be my advice.
Perfect. I think I missed on our question of Mr. Hitesh. So he's again written it down. Sorry for that inconvenience, sir. So the question is, walking 20 to 25 minutes on a treadmill is enough? 20 to 25 minutes is a good time. Even,
Yeah, it's good enough. But again, I would say treadmill is doing half your job. Don't you think, Dr. Ajit, it's better to walk outside in open air? But yeah, in the COVID scenario, if you have
treadmill. You cannot go out, 20 to 25 minutes, I think personally, that's what I follow. It's a good thing. Yeah.
Again, it depends on your, whether you're keeping an inclined position, whether what is the speed. So if you're just doing it at a very low speed, then it will not be so much beneficial. But if you're doing it at a higher speed, it will be more beneficial in losing your excess fat.
Perfect. Yeah. Question from Mr. Sridhar. Latest food pyramid chart according to Corona Challenge, based on Corona Challenge. So do we have to change into the pyramid chart, because since everyone is scared about this pandemic and Corona, is there any change in the overall pyramid chart?
There is no, you need to eat a healthy diet. But yes, during the phase of when you're suffering from the COVID, when if you're infected by COVID, I would say have more of liquids, more of warm liquids like soup and moong soup and all the vegetable soups that will give you antioxidants. Then you can have a lot of light food, but healthy food like homemade options, not too spicy foods, okay? And eat fruits and eat in between. So I think mainly there's no change in the pyramid for COVID patients. But yes, you have to focus on high protein diet and more of vegetables and soups and fruits. So basically vitamin C rich foods again, like amla is in the season. Have one amla a day, that will help you.
Sure. Next is from, what are the best timings for meals? Okay. Depends on whether you're working from home or you're at office.
What are your best timings for?
Meals. So what time ideally you should go for?
Now, again, there is a lot of intermediate fasting which people have started doing it. I'm not a believer or a fan of intermediate fasting. I believe 10 to 12 hours is a good enough of time. And eating breakfast is very important from my point of scenario, because your body is empty. So skipping your breakfast is not a good thing to do. And eating your dinner 3 hours before your bedtime. Please start doing that. I have seen people eating at 10, sleeping at 10:30, eating at 12 o'clock, sleeping at 12:30. So your digest, there's no time for your body to digest the food, and it all gets accumulated as your abdominal fat. So please try to make your dinner 3 hours before your bedtime. Eat your breakfast, lunch, dinner, three main meals. In between, a light, some healthy snack, which is not very heavy and which gives you protein and vitamins and minerals.
Perfect. Next question is from Mr. Sanket. What are the best options for snacks on the go? Also, are fruits recommended to consume in evening or night?
Yeah, so
this best question, we get it every webinar, right?
Yeah, we get this question every time. The thing is, I don't advise fruits post 7 p.m. Okay. True. And best options for snacks are, you can have roasted chana is very handy and very cheaply available. So a mixture of singh chana is very good to take with you. Then again, khakras are available diet, moong khakras, or jawar bajri khakras are good options again. Then makhana, as I had said, buttermilk is a very good, if you're going out, you can carry a glass of homemade buttermilk. Amul chas is available everywhere. So you can have buttermilk, coconut water in between if you are outside, you don't go for the sodas and all. So certain, there are many healthy options. Only thing we all are aware by that particular time, our mind goes us to have a vada pav or a samosa pav, but you can think of me, remember me, and go for the healthy options.
There's also lots of questions related to aerated drinks, thumbs up, Pepsi or Coke.
Yeah.
Are found, of such kind of, aerated drinks whenever they go out, rather than, sipping in, as you said, chas or a lassi, they would rather prefer a Coke or, a kind of a aerated drink like Fanta, Coke or thumbs up. So your take on this, ma'am? This is one of my personal questions, because I've seen people around me who are fond of such kind of aerated drinks. So your take on this, ma'am?
Yeah. So I think mainly because of the advertisements and all that, people have been so much ingrained into having this cola drink. But I see nowadays people are have started avoiding these, yes, because of the awareness. They are providing you empty calories. It's filling your stomach, but it is not giving you any vitamins or minerals or protein.
Mm-hmm.
So people are realizing it, and they know that they are going to put on weight if they are going to have it. So what I feel that when I take the history of my patients, I see many people are avoiding these things, cola drinks, as of now.
Mm-hmm.
But there is again all these, I would say, the energy drinks now. The energy drinks, people, please don't start having all this. The energy drinks which have come up in the market.
And they have this marketing gimmick also. So initially it was Coke, now it is Diet Coke. So you
Diet Coke is more dangerous than the normal Coke.
Correct,
don't go for diet. If you feel like having a Coke, go for a normal Coke, because Diet Coke is added by a lot of other additives which are harmful for our health.
Correct. Okay. Next question is, how can we increase oxygen levels, especially affected with some symptoms? I mean, COVID symptoms, I guess.
Again, I think oxygen is related to your lung capacity. So doing pranayama and breathing exercises will be more beneficial to you. So improving your lung functioning, I think food doesn't have any relation with the oxygen levels. Am I right, Dr. Ajit?
Correct. However, yes, for your certain foods, as rightly said, you know, you can have this antioxidant feature into it. However, that
also
is not
going. Also, when you're having a balanced diet with lot of, then you're getting that antioxidants.
Right? Correct, but that is not going to increase your oxygen.
That will not help you.
There's no direct relation as such.
Yes.
Otherwise, what people will do is they'll check their SpO2 and start having food and increase their oxygen, you know. So that is not a case anyways. Next question is from Mr. Sandeep. For sweet cravings, is dark chocolate fine? I mean, even I am fond of dark chocolate, by the way. So
yeah, you can take, but I would say a khajur or an anjeer is a better option than the dark chocolate. But yeah, once in a while, dark chocolate is fine. It is not harmful if it's taken in small quantities.
It's more of a celebration rather than a diet, actually.
Yeah.
When you're happy, you can have
this. When you're having khajur and anjeer, you're getting even iron and everything, right? Sure. So the fiber. So that is a better option.
So once in a while, it is good, I guess. But
yeah,
not,
once in a while, everything is good, because we want to enjoy life also. We don't want to live a punished life, right? So I would say enjoy at times, but be careful at the most of the times.
Okay. Next is, which food helps against gastric problems? Okay.
Again, there are many kinds of gastric problems like diarrhea, constipation, IBS. So again, it's very individualized. So I can't have a general answer. For some people, sprouts can cause gastric problems. For some people, fermented foods can give gastric problems. So it's again individualized. But having soaked methi in the night, or in the soaking your methi seeds and having that methi and water, that will decrease your acidity. So there are certain natural remedies like sauf and black raisins soaking in water, having early morning, will reduce acidity. So all that is good. But there's not a single food which will, again, depending on the symptoms, you have to avoid that food.
Correct.
So, again, it's an individual question.
Okay. Your opinion on meal replacement protein shakes?
Meal replacement protein shakes, again, it depends on the... it's depending on the what are your activities. For example, you're an obese person and you are trying to lose weight, and with a normal weight loss diet, you're not losing weight. Then we do recommend for 10 days, 15 days, I recommend a meal replacement instead of dinner. But again, it is very individualized. Please don't start playing with these supplements on your own. So, and whey supplements are important for people who are literally into gymming and they are not getting enough protein from their regular diet. So then we try to tell them to have whey protein supplements. So it depends on person to person. Again, here the same rule. There's no rule to all. Exceptions are always there. So depending on your requirements, we plan.
Okay, perfect. I think no further questions is what we have as of now. Any other questions, if you guys have, you can directly, send it to me. I'm just putting down my number over here, along with my name. So if you have any further queries, you can definitely get in touch with us. Okay. That's fine. not able to send this. Oh, sorry. Everyone in the meeting. Perfect. So that's my number. You can get in touch with me for any help related to health or related to diet also. And thank you, sir, once again, Smigda ma'am, for such a wonderful session. As always, you know, we enjoy this session together, you know, with such questions and answers. So well explained, and I can see the feedback also. Wonderful session. So guys, we keep on having such kind of a sessions. You know, next is on PCOS, which is on 19th. Again from Quantum. So, you know, I would request everyone to again be a part of that session as well. If you have any questions related to that, you can put in the question to me. I'll forward the same to Ms. Snigdha. And then if you want any consultations also, definitely we can, we'll be happy to, you know, give you that service as well. So for time being, you know, take care, stay safe, guys. And, you know, hope we all are out of this pandemic and the third suspected wave. Thank you once again, Mr. Sridhar, for giving us the feedback. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe, stay healthy. Take care. Thank you.
Thanks, everyone. Thank you. Bye.